Now brings us to Las Vegas, Nevada. The atmosphere here, electric. No matter the venue, the home folks love their silver and black. They are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with the Minnesota Vikings. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Las Vegas' offense back out there ready to go. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Here's Carr to throw. He'll find his tight end. That's Waller. 7 yards, the pickup there.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Takes it to the 26, just a 1 yard gain. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
An early test, two plays in. This is third and two. Try to run for it with Jacobs. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
I think that's how this defense is going to need to play these tight ends. Again, get right up on them and stay physical. And that paid off on that play, helping force that incompletion.
Second and 10. Now Carr. That's complete to his tight end, Waller. And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that. Well, I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's 3 catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. 3 catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone setter. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
Here's 2nd and 10. Here's Carr. He'll swing that out wide to Jacobs. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. That'll leave them with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
And Jacobs, I don't think he's going to get there, no. It appears they're going to mark him short of the first. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. Juke, now he's got some room, and he'll get this up to the 34-yard line.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
They run again on first down, Cook. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
Well, sometimes as a running back, you've got to be able to improvise when the hole's not where you expect it to be. But in this case, there wasn't any improvisation that he could do that was going to work. Kind of like if you're trying to be a comedian on open mic night at the Improv and you run into a tough crowd.
From the 36, Mannion. Complete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Fair catch called. It's taken in right at the 20-yard line. We're scoreless after one. Second quarter from Vegas. The home standing Raiders with a football here. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. They've been playing the field position game thus far. No score. Second quarter as they come up on first and 10. They'll begin on the ground with Jacobs. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Carr going to give it to Jacobs. And he's upended after a gain of four, up to the 25-yard line.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
The Raiders on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and five. Throwing now is Carr. And he'll look downfield for Waller. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Two drives won't tell the story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get on track in this one.
Here's A.J. Cole now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. The Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind, trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Get ready.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Throwing is Mannion. Lets it fly for Thielen. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up third and 10. Here's Mannion. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Offensively lucky there, able to keep the football, but now fourth down, so they'll have to boot it away.
I do think, though, they're going to look at this as a positive. One, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession. But two, being able to punt it changes field position for them. Imagine if that turnover takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. We've seen both of these offenses still sort of in that figuring things out phase, but I suspect some action on the scoreboard soon as they start. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. The defensive end, Danielle Hunter, drops him.
It seemed like he kept going through those progressions, and I thought he might dump that underneath, but he couldn't get rid of the football in time.
And I have to wonder if he was thinking while he was back there, I wish there were a lot less progressions on this play, just someone that I can dump the ball to and get it out of my hands.
To try again after the sack, Carr. Short throw, going to be caught by Waller. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Throwing his car on third down. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there that brings up fourth.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's A.J. Cole now, as he's on to punt for Vegas. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Taken in at the 22. A 39-yard punt, a return of five, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again.
It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain on the screen there. It's second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Looking to throw again on second down. Mannion. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. This time they stay on the ground. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Here's Jordan Berry now as he's on to punt for Minnesota. That's what the punt goes for. Five on the return. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime.
The Raider offense heading back for one final first half drive. And with only 4 seconds on the clock, time likely for just one snap of the football.
The white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. And we will likely not see another play here as they take the knee and head into the intermission all tied. So plenty of action on the field, but no action right now on the scoreboard, at least as of yet. Nothing, nothing is our score. As we send you to our EA Studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. And the Vikings set to go on offense to begin the third quarter.
And we thought this game had the potential to be tight, maybe not this tight, scoreless as we start the third quarter.
And I love the way you use the word tight. I'm going to take it a little bit different direction here because it's not just tight on the scoreboard. I think both offenses have been tight in how they've played this game. No one's been loose. No one's been free. They've got to find a way to make some plays, and I don't think you do it if you're really tight in everything that you're doing in the game.
Jonathan Hankins in on the stop.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Second and 8 coming up.
Again, it's Cook. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags.
Well, when you get an elite running back like he is, sometimes you've got to employ the by any means necessary method to get him down.
Yeah, sometimes you're relieved even if a flag comes out. But if you just get the hand up and you get it on the mask, you can kind of get away with that. But as soon as you curl it around a finger or the hand, that's pretty easy for everyone to see. And they'll call that one every time.
They run it again with Cook. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. A give. This is Cook. Dances by him. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
Following the good run by Cook, here's another first and 10. And now here's a carry heading left. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And down he goes, brought down, a Raider sack. Max Crosby, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely, going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
Is there any way they can find something that can pop, something big to knock them back on their heels?
That'll be complete to Cook. And he'll be taken down well before the first at about the 36-yard line. A gain of 9, not enough, and it's fourth down.
Brandon, it certainly looked like they had that play defended well, but it still almost worked. Got it to the running back. He wound up getting really good yardage out of it, but it was third and long, and they were able to rally and stop it before he could get to the marker.
And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. Thought that might be the goose egg breaker. Still stuck on 0.
Yeah, this is still a tight game, too. We got to keep that in mind because that miss there, you hang your head, you let it affect you the next time you go out there, then you've really hurt your ball club. Get yourself together. You might get another opportunity, and they're going to...
And he will not get away from the pressure here. Carr taken down. Danielle Hunter able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
And keep in mind, in addition to the two sacks that he now has, CD, he's also had a couple of quarterback hurries. He's been very disruptive.
To put it mildly, and it reminds me of the time I asked an offensive tackle who struggled like this in a game, is he said he was telling the coach, hey, what do you want me to do? This guy's just eating me alive. And the coach finally just looked at him and said, applaud.
So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll be 3rd and 10 now.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Let's this go for Renfro downfield. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on 3rd down. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's 1st and goal. Carr now to throw. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. Danielle Hunter able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his 3rd sack of the afternoon.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, it took a sack on 1st and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
Second down and goal. Carr, that's caught by Waller out left side. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this 3rd down play as we've played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. They'll run with Jacobs. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. The defense may be content to give him 9 there as it brings up 4th and goal. Have to kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. The kick by Carlson is good. And the Raiders jump out to a 3-0 advantage.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
Kenny Nwangu now out of his end zone.
And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. Minnesota now ready for their next possession.
I tell you what, it's kind of hard to imagine. They have not scored a single point, and yet they're in this position. A touchdown drive here, and they're in the lead.
Normally, when you have zero on your side of the ledger on the scoreboard, you're a little bit discouraged. But when they look over and see their opponents, they don't see a number that's way out there. They don't see a number they can't attain. In fact, they can get it right here on this drive and potentially take...
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Rakiasin. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score.
Well, this has been a hard-fought ball game. Offense could never really get on track, and that pick six might just write a close to this one.
Well, let's give credit to the defense on this one, because they pitched a shutout the entire way, and did it put the icing on the cake, the cherry on top of the sundae. They created points themselves with the pick six. How about that for a defensive play of the game and a defense that's dominated throughout?
Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And the lead grows to 10-0. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
Nwangu now from his end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
And now out comes Minnesota. We'll see if they can band back together after the pick six. It hurt badly, but still within striking distance. A two-score game with a good chunk of time on the clock. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back at the 2. Chandler Jones, credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
I think most quarterbacks would love to have the goal line actually extend up into the air and turn into a wall, and they can put their back against it and know exactly where they are on the field so they don't end up in the end zone. Didn't do it on that play, but perilously close to the goal line.
Oh, look at the juke. 60 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
To throw now on first down. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Rakiasin. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. Here's Jacobs on first and 10. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Carnell on first down. And that's complete to Adams. And the Raiders are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Here's Jacobs. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it to football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
Line of scrimmage, again the four-yard line. Second and goal. One more time with Jacobs. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the one. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Back to throw, Carr. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Great defense there on third and goal. They took away everything, forced him to fire that one to the sideline where no one could get it.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. Carlson able to put this one through. And that'll push the lead up to 13-0. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it's still eight up time, gap points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Nwangu now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So all eyes on this Vikings offense. Down by 13. And time, a huge factor. They've yet to score all game long, but now they need to do so twice in short order to have a shot. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. His throw incomplete.
Well, they've certainly had trouble unlocking this defense through 3.5 quarters, so I don't expect it to get any easier now. You know they're going to be sitting back and waiting on everything, and they force an incompletion there.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all, and now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's 1st and 10. They'll look to throw. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. I think you'd agree that looked like the right call from up here.
No doubt about it. And what everyone has to understand is that the officials are going to be right on the play each and every time. You may not like the call, but they're usually spot on.
So a critical mistake, roughing the passer. Now it's 1st and goal. They'll look to throw here. And he's going to go down, sacked right around the 17. Max Crosby in there to drop him as that clock continues to run.
Well, that's not how you hope to draw it up there on 1st and goal, CD, by taking a sack like that.
Well, they tried to be aggressive, didn't they? They didn't want to try and work their way past the goal line. They wanted it right there on that play. Unfortunately, it backfired against them. Now they have to try and pick it up here moving forward.
Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
Too many zeros on the stat sheet thus far. No touchdown passes, no points for his team, but he remains undaunted. Still attempting to get his team on the scoreboard, firing the ball downfield.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. They'll set up to throw. And this is caught for a touchdown. So hang on now. Things just got a little bit more interesting here in the final minute. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
Extra point right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So a little under 50 seconds to go. Plenty of time if they can get this onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
The Raiders heading out to take over. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. And right side, they're going to go option here. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down. Carr down to a knee, and that ought to just about do it.
I don't know about you, partner, but watching them take the knee there and finish this one off, I feel like I'm going to be sore tomorrow. This was one bruising affair. Low scoring, but my kind of football.
Not a work of art, but maybe in your world, a little bit of a work of art. You like the defensive side.
I thought it was pretty. I can't help myself. I thought it was pretty.
And it ends in a kneel down as the clock rolls down to zeros. Well, Charles, a one-score game. Down to the end we went. They had one final play in that one-score game. We all knew what was coming, the Hail Mary. They just couldn't get it done.
Wasn't exactly complicated, was it? We all knew, as you said, and go long and see if we can find someone open. They didn't get it done. Someone's happy. Someone is not.